would go on to renew her beautician license for years, just in case she needed a backup plan.
Which, of course, she did not.
So Miss Emmylou Harris, another good one, and she's gonna be in town at Red Butte, I think, later this season, right? So she is another really great, prolific songwriter, all of this stuff, but she's actually credited for kind of saving the Ryman Auditorium. The Ryman, the mother church of country music, kind of plopped right there in the middle of Nashville. When the Grand Ole Opry moved to its new home, the Ryman really kind of became dilapidated, and they were really threatening to tear it down. And she went in and did some shows, and they did live recordings of these shows, and nobody could sit in the balcony, and nobody could sit underneath the balcony for safety concerns. But the recordings of these concerts really brought renewed interest in the Ryman, and so we still have that beautiful building that we get to use today. So Miss Emmylou Harris, now we're thinking about two more bottles of wine, guys. So when it's two more, I want to see your two more bottles up here. Right? Guitar, you guys. These guys are such great. How many years would you say y'all have done music?
Together we have over 200 years of musical experience. True, no lie. We've all been playing since we were about 15 together.
Some of them did the, who remembers the Lagoon Marching Band?
Oh, yeah! Woo!
I think you all were except Mark, who was in L.A.?
Well, different shows. We all played at Lagoon.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, and Mark joined later, so we are all Lagoon.
Lagoon Marching Band. Who misses the Lagoon Marching Band?
They won't let 50-year-olds march at Lagoon anymore.
Not as cute in the white pants, or what? Dave also did. Anyone, the Utah Jazz Band?
Played back in the 80s, all the jazz games, and at one time or another, all of these guys were there with me as well.
They're Utah institutions, guys, except so young.
Maybe. I'm sorry, we've been in a Utah institution? Is that what you said?
You, Kendall.
You guys, once you get them started, you'll never be able to reel them in. We're going to slow it down a little bit. This gal is, she was one of the first female outlaws of country music, which was a very rare distinction, and she was number 9 on the list, which when you're talking about Willie Waylon and Merle and the boys, that's, you're keeping some pretty intense company. She had quite a career. She began at 13. She lived in St. George for a time. She tried to really change her image from the 13-year-old, and she's gone on. She's still recording. In fact, she was out on tour and right now, but she had hip surgery, so she had to delay it while she heals. Miss Tanya Tucker. She has a new album out too, Tandy Does, came out last year, right during the middle of COVID, so I hope you downloaded it. So let's go from one 13-year-old to another 13-year-old. We'll kind of keep in this little, this is what I remember about her. I remember she sang with her sisters and they had a TV show, the Mandrell Sisters. They have a TV show, and I just remember she was so pretty, and she just had those glossy lips and those big eyes, and oh, her glossy lipstick, it was amazing. But I love to learn. She was an incredible musician. She was really a child prodigy. At 13, she'd mastered several instruments, pedal steel, banjo, saxophone, guitar. She was so good at the pedal steel. She went on tour with Patsy Cline and Johnny Cash and George Jones. I have a 13-year-old. I wouldn't send her out on the road with that group. But Patsy Cline, so she played for Patsy. Patsy was so impressed, she ended up writing a letter to someone saying, I played with this 13-year-old blonde doll who is a hell of a musician. So she also married the drummer, the Mandrell Sisters drummer, and they're still married, which I think is neat, because that's a very long time. So we're gonna do a little sleeping single in a double bit.
Sorry, 'cause drinking doubles alone don't make it a party. Another sleepless night, yeah, it's the same old story. When you're the only one, at 2 a.m. I'll sleep single in a double bed, thinking over things I wish I'd said. Should have held you, but I let you go. Now I'm the one sleeping all alone. Sleeping single in a double bed, tossing, turning, trying to forget. I could be lying with you instead of sleeping single in a double bed.
Some glowy, like big long glow sticks. They look like lightsabers up there. Someone went to Comic-Con. You know, I showed pictures from the last time I was here, which is a handful of years ago, but one of the things I love about this house and this space and kind of being able to see you is you're all mouthing along to every single word, every single song, so I love that. If you feel like you want to get up and dance at some point too, that's fine. Let's go from 13-year-olds and we're going to kick it way up a notch, all the way up into the 40s. 45. Whoa, right? This woman has the amazing distinction of being the only one